But also we are learning that a lot of the opposition political parties are actually the ones that are instigating and inciting violence.
But how? In your own primaries?
Yes, yes, they are doing that because one, they are interested in the outcome of the primaries. And of course, they're interested in the outcomes for obvious reasons that whoever finally contends with them must be someone weaker. And but I can assure them that whoever comes out of these primaries will be able to face them.
Do you have those results? Do you have actually evidence of that?
We have evidence in some instances, and I think it is with the relevant authorities. I'm not going to really dwell into that, but I can guarantee you that many of the violence, a lot of the violence is from the opposition. They are the ones trying to incite, to make us appear
opposition in
bad
NRM.
In the political light. No, opposition.
Yes,
not in NRM. Not in NRM.
Yes, I understand.
Many of them from New, is it New? I don't know what they call it.
We understand outside forces.
Yes, outside our political. Many of our people have been peaceful. They've been in these elections before, and we always ensure that when one person wins, the others support. That's why we try as much as possible to harmonize them before this prime. Because at the end of the day, you've seen in some instances where 15 people are nominated for a political office, and one will go through eventually. So we
Absolutely.
Expect the 14 to support the other. So, but we are ready for whoever wants to cause violence at those scenes, because the forces will take over and ensure that lives and property is protected.
That's right. And yes. Also, the electoral commission chairperson said that if there's violence in your area, your election probably will be cancelled. So it will be rescheduled. Mm-hmm.